we come on to what are the different types of business services that we are going to be focusing on or studying about. Number one being, we have about five: banking, insurance, postal services, transportation and warehousing. If you recall, humne first chapter mein kiya tha that these are basically nothing else but auxiliaries to trade. These are nothing else but auxiliaries to trade. Fine. All these business services, they remove various hindrances, be it of time, be it of place, be it of information. Okay. Now, let us take each one of them one by one. Talking about banking, what is the main function of a bank? They accept deposits repayable on demand or after a fixed period of time. A layman's understanding of bank would be that you go deposit your money over there, right? You will earn a fixed amount of interest, fine, and जबी भी मेरे को पैसे की जरूरत हो मैं वहां से निकलवा सकती हूँ, या अगर मैंने कोई फिक्स टाइम पीरियड के लिए डिपॉजिट लिया है तो जब वो मच्योर होगा तो मुझे पैसे वापस मिल जाएंगे. दिस इज व्हाट अ लेमन्स अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ बैंक इज. ओके, नाउ अनदर फंक्शन दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट हियर इज, इट इज नॉट ओनली दैट बैंक्स आर देयर दैट यू गो पुट योर मनी ओवर देयर एंड दे विल पे यू इंटरेस्ट. आपने कभी ये सोचा कि आप तो अपना पैसा वहां पे डिपॉजिट कराते हैं, मैंने अपना लेट्स से अबाउट फ्यू लैक्स करा दिया, किसी और ने 5 लाख 6 लाख व्हाटएवर, देन बैंक के पास पैसा कहां से आता है आपको इंटरेस्ट देने के लिए? ओके, सो बैंक्स दे एनकरेज पीपल टू सेव मनी एंड पुट इट इन डिपॉजिट्स और सेविंग्स अकाउंट्स, राइट? देन फर्दर बैंक्स दे मोबिलाइज द सेविंग्स ऑफ द पीपल एंड मेक फंड्स अवेलेबल टू बिजनेस एंटरप्राइजेस इन द फॉर्म्स ऑफ लोन. ओके, नाउ after you have deposited money in the bank, theek hai, after retaining a specific amount of money as is required by the RBI, after keeping that specific amount of money aside, the remaining amount of money is extended as loan to different business enterprises who in turn pay interest to the bank. तो बैंक कहां से पैसा कमा रहा है? बैंक कह रहा है जो आपका पैसा है उसको वो आगे लोन की तरह एक्सटेंड कर रहा है औरों को, ठीक है, एंड वो लोग बैंक को इंटरेस्ट पे करते हैं और उसी अमाउंट में से आपका इंटरेस्ट बैंक देता है. ऑलराइट, सो दिस होल प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज बेसिकली नथिंग एल्स बट दे आर बैंक्स आर मोबिलाइजिंग सेविंग्स, ओके, एंड इज मेकिंग दिस मनी अवेलेबल टू द वेरियस बिजनेस एंटरप्राइजेस इन द फॉर्म्स ऑफ लोन्स. Right? Now coming to which are the different types of banks here. Commercial banks. Commercial banks ka main purpose kya hota hai? That is to accept deposit from the people. Okay? Then to give loans, to extend loans. Alright? Then cooperative bank. And cooperative banks kaun se? Cooperative banks, they basically come under the purview of the Cooperative Societies Act. And the main aim of these cooperative banks is to provide cheap loans to its members. Fine. Then, so when we talk about specialized banks are basically the foreign exchange banks and industrial and development banks. Okay. Then central bank. Now, central bank, it basically regulates the functioning of all other banks of a country. Fine. And which is the central bank of India? It is the Reserve Bank of India. Fine. Alright, now coming to what are the different functions of commercial banks. We are taking up functions of commercial banks. Kya functions hote hain commercial bank ke? First and the foremost function of a commercial bank is that of acceptance of deposits. Theek hai? Logon ke paise accept karna. Ab logon ke paise accept karna, uske liye there are different type of schemes which these commercial banks have, different types of accounts which these commercial banks have. Number one being current account. Fine. This current account, the facility of the current account is basically available for all the business enterprises, and the account holders, they are free to make deposits and withdraw money without any limitation on number of withdrawals. ओके, दे डू नॉट गेट एनी इंटरेस्ट. यहां पे दे आर फ्री टू मेक द एनी नंबर ऑफ विड्रॉल्स एंड डिपॉजिट्स दैट दे वांट टू मेक, बट दे डू नॉट गेट एनी इंटरेस्ट ऑन दैट. which means that it is only like a locker. You go put your money over there. Next day, if you want to withdraw it, you can do that. You can withdraw money n number of times. You can deposit money n number of times. There is no limitation on that. Then next comes your savings account. Fine. It is open with a very small amount of money, and there is a minimum amount that you are supposed to, minimum balance that you are supposed to have in the savings account. And this idea of savings account basically is the main reason for having savings account was to basically promote the habit of saving amongst people. Right? There is a limitation onto the number of times you can withdraw money or deposit money, and definitely there is a, you do get interest on your savings. Fine. I don't know how many of you have really done that, but aap apna debit card bhi agar use karenge, you cannot withdraw, there is a limit, you cannot withdraw more than 20,000 rupees in a day. Okay, because that debit card that you have, it is connected to your savings account. After that comes recurring deposit account. Recurring deposit mein kya hota hai? This again, like I'll tell you, let us suppose if I'm earning a salary of about 80,000 rupees. Fine. And if I get a recurring deposit done out of my salary for 50,000, to jaise hi meri salary mere account mein aayegi, automatically 50,000 rupees straight will go to another account, which is called as a recurring deposit account. Har mahine meri salary mein se 50,000 wahan pe jama hote rahenge. I can open a RD for 1 year or 2 year as the case may be, right? Iske upar bhi aapko interest milta hai. Fine, this is also to encourage savings amongst people. Then comes your fixed deposit account. Fixed deposit account, we also aapne FD ke naam se suna hoga iska. Fine, isme kya hota hai, that it is done for a specific amount of money. It can be done for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, as the case may be, jaisa aapka, whatever suits the customer, fine. Fine, but that money is fixed for that period of time. Agar maine 4 lakh ki FD karai hai 4 saal ke liye, to 4 saal ke liye mere 4 lakh rupees are fixed. I cannot touch that 4 lakh rupees. And the rate of interest that I'm going to get is definitely going to be higher than what I'm going to get in savings account. ठीक है? और अगर मैच्योरिटी से पहले अगर आप एफडी तोड़ाते हैं अपनी, तो आपको रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट को थोड़ा सैक्रिफाइस करना पड़ता है, बिकॉज यू हैव ब्रोकन योर प्रॉमिस विद द बैंक. आपने कहा था बैंक को कि 5 लाख मुझे आपको 5 साल के लिए दे रही हूं. उससे पहले अगर आपने एफडी तोड़ाई, तो डेफिनेटली आपको प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट पूरा मिलेगा, बट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट में से आपका थोड़ा सा काट लिया जाएगा. देन मल्टीपल ऑप्शन डिपॉजिट. मल्टीपल ऑप्शन डिपॉजिट क्या है? In this case, this deposit is linked to depositor's savings account. ये आपके savings account से linked है. Fine. And as I told you कि savings account में कुछ minimum balance आपको maintain करके रखना होता है. आपने check issue किया, let us say 50,000 का, और आपके savings account में है only about 35,000. Okay. So if you have a multiple option deposit account, automatically जितना amount कम पड़ रहा है will be transferred from multiple option to the savings account. For a, definitely for a short period of time. Clear? So these are the 5 different types of accounts over here that we have studied. Alright? Second function of commercial bank is of lending of funds. As I just explained to you, that how does bank perform this function of lending? आपने पहले डिपॉजिट्स एक्सेप्ट किए, उसमें से एक सर्टेन परसेंटेज अपने पास रख के, बिकॉज कभी भी कोई भी अपना पैसा वापस डिमांड कर सकता है, द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, ठीक है, मिनिमम जो हम रखते हैं वो कैसे डिसाइड होता है, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिटेल, बट देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कैश रिजर्व रेशियो, CRR. ओके, उतना आप रख के, देन द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट इज सर्क्यूलेटेड, इट इज एक्सटेंडेड एज लोन टू अदर बिजनेस एंटरप्राइजेस. नाउ when you lend money in the form of loans, you do charge some rate of interest on the same. Okay, and that is a source of earning for the bank, and out of that earning only bank pays interest on the deposits that it has accepted from the people. All right, thereafter banks, commercial banks, they also give check facility. Aapko kabhi bhi kisi bhi account mein se paise withdraw karne, you have to issue a check for the same. This facility is also provided by the commercial banks, right? Then when we are talking about checks, again there are 2 types of checks. One is a bearer check and the other one is the account pay check or a cross check. Okay. Now, when we talk about the bearer check, which is payable over the counter. बियरर चेक इज जिसके पास चेक है उसको पैसे मिल जाएंगे. अगर मैंने अपने नाम का चेक काटा है जहां पे लिखा है ना पे टू सेल्फ, ओके नीचे साइन कर दिए मैंने अपने, एंड इफ आई ड्रॉप दैट चेक एनीवेयर, जिसने भी उठा लिया वो जाके काउंटर, ही कैन टेक विड्रॉ मनी आउट ऑफ माई अकाउंट ओवर द काउंटर एंड नो वन कैन क्वेश्चन हिम. इसमें एक बार पैसे चले गए तो वो आपके पास वापस नहीं आते हैं, राइट. देन अकाउंट पे चेक. नाउ अकाउंट पे चेक क्या होता है, दैट इफ आई हैव टू इश्यू अ चेक टू लेट्स से मिस्टर ए, ओके सो पे टू ऑलराइट मिस्टर ए, मिस्टर ए लिख दिया मैंने, एंड ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड कॉर्नर ऑफ द चेक आई हैव पुट टू लाइंस, ऑलराइट दिस मींस फ्रॉम माय अकाउंट मनी विल बी ट्रांसफर टू द अकाउंट ऑफ मिस्टर ए. ओवर द काउंटर कोई पेमेंट नहीं होगी, एक अकाउंट में से दूसरे अकाउंट में पैसे जाएंगे, वो होता है किसमें, अकाउंट पे चेक में. फाइन, देन कम्स योर रेमिटेंस ऑफ फंड्स. ओके, नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक ऑफ रेमिटेंस ऑफ फंड्स, इट इज बाय यूजिंग बैंक चेक्स, बैंक ड्राफ्ट्स, पे ऑर्डर्स, मेल ट्रांसफर्स ओवर अ नॉमिनल कमीशन चार्ज बाय द बैंक. नाउ ओवर हियर ओनली आई विल डिस्कस दैट व्हाट इज दिस व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट बैंक ड्राफ्ट्स. आपने right now you know after class 12th when you fill forms for this different entrance exams, kya hota hai that if I have to sit for an entrance exam let's say, theek hai, aur jis institute ka entrance exam hai wo entrance fee aap se mangenge and they will demand for a bank draft of a particular bank, let's say andhra bank ka, theek hai, wo kis liye, kyunki unka khud ka jo institution ka account hai wo hai andhra bank mein, all right. To आपको क्या करना होगा, यू विल हैव टू गो टू आंध्रा बैंक. मुझे लेट्स से कहो अबाउट 500 रुपीज का बैंक ड्राफ्ट बनवाना है, आई विल पे 500 रुपीज प्लस सम एक्स्ट्रा कमीशन टू आंध्रा बैंक पीपल, दे विल इश्यू अ बैंक ड्राफ्ट टू मी. ये बैंक ड्राफ्ट जब मैं एबीसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को दूंगी जहां पे मुझे एग्जाम के लिए बैठना है, ओके, व्हेन दीज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पीपल दे प्रेजेंट द सेम बैंक ड्राफ्ट इन देयर ब्रांच ऑफ आंध्रा अकाउंट आंध्रा बैंक, ऑलराइट, तो जहां मैंने पैसे दिए हैं, जहां से मैंने बैंक ड्राफ्ट बनवाया है, उस ब्रांच से उनकी ब्रांच में इजीली मनी ट्रांसफर हो जाएगा. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज योर रेमिटेंस ऑफ फंड्स. ठीक है, रेमिटेंस का मेन मतलब क्या है, ट्रांसफर. व्हेन वी टॉक ऑफ रेमिटेंस इट मींस ट्रांसफर, ठीक है, ट्रांसफर ऑफ फंड्स फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. All right, it can be done with the help of bank drafts or bank orders, etc. Then, last but not the least, the banks also provide us some allied services like locker facilities. Fine, you must have seen your parents operating the locker where they keep their jewelry and all. Banks provide you that kind of locker facility. You do have to pay some amount of extra money to the banks. Okay. Now, after this, coming to types of the advances. Now types of advances, when we talk about loans, we can say short term loans. ठीक है, bank overdraft होता है, but bank overdraft facility is only open to people having current account. Bank overdraft facility is only available for current account. All right, you can overdraw your current account. आपके account में जितने पैसे हैं आप उससे ज्यादा withdraw कर सकते हैं, ओके, पर जितना अमाउंट लेट अस से 40,000 है, तो अगर मैंने 80,000, पर उसकी कुछ लिमिट होती है, मैंने 80,000 का चेक काट दिया, ठीक है, आई कैन ओवरड्रॉ माय अकाउंट, बट जितने से लिया है दैट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ शॉर्ट टर्म लोन एंड आई विल हैव टू पे इंटरेस्ट ऑन दैट, राइट. उसके बाद लेट्स टॉक अबाउट कैश क्रेडिट. नाउ कैश क्रेडिट इज जब आप इफ यू गिव समथिंग एज अ सिक्योरिटी टू द बैंक, लेट अस से आई हैव गिवन माय ऑफिस बिल्डिंग एज अ सिक्योरिटी टू बैंक, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द सिक्योरिटी बैंक गिव्स यू अ क्रेडिट लिमिट. बैंक आपको एक क्रेडिट लिमिट देता है, ठीक है, एंड यू कैन विदड्रॉ अप टू दैट क्रेडिट लिमिट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई विल टेक द सेम एग्जाम्पल दैट आई हैव गिवन इन द बुक ऑल्सो. इफ आई हैव गिवन अ सिक्योरिटी एंड माई लिमिट ऑफ विड्रॉल इज 10 लाख as on 31st March 2014 and I withdraw on 1st April 2014 2 lakh rupees, okay, so bank will charge interest from me on rupees 2 lakh starting from 1st April 2014 till the period I return that money back, clear. And agar main mereko jaise limit mili hui hai 10 lakh ki, theek hai, usko underdraw karne pe bhi Fine, like it is written over here, interest will be charged on 2 lakh from 1st April 2014 only. However, banks levy commitment charges in order to recover loss of interest due to underutilization of credit limit. Now, what does this mean? बैंक आपसे लेता है कमिट लेवी कमिटमेंट चार्जेस. आपको आपने अपनी बिल्डिंग मॉर्गेज की, आपको 10 लाख की क्रेडिट लिमिट मिली. इसका मतलब बैंक ये मान के चलता है कि आपको 10 लाख की जरूरत है. क्लियर? देयरफॉर अगर आप 10 लाख ना विड्रॉ करके उससे बहुत कम अमाउंट विड्रॉ कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, तो बैंक ने तो वो 10 लाख आपके लिए रिजर्व करके रखा हुआ ना, कि बिकॉज आपने अपनी बिल्डिंग मॉर्गेज की है, बैंक ने वो 10 लाख आपके लिए साइड पे करके रखा है. अब अगर आप वो बैंक से नहीं लेते हो, सो बैंक इज लूजिंग ऑन टू इंटरेस्ट. बैंक इज लूजिंग ऑन टू इंटरेस्ट, तो बैंक आपके ऊपर कमिटमेंट चार्जेस लगाएगा. क्लियर? नाउ दिस वॉज अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ एडवांसेस. नाउ कमिंग टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फंड ट्रांसफर्स. नंबर वन बींग RTGS, that is real time gross settlement. It means now money can be transferred from one bank to another bank without wasting any time. When we say real time, it means on actual time basis, there will be no waiting time for 2 to 3 days. Fine. And it is done on gross basis, it is not clubbed with any other transaction. Alright, but the minimum amount, it is generally done for big amounts and the minimum limit being 2 lakh rupees. Alright, then we have NEFT, that is your National Electronic Fund Transfer. Here, the money can be transferred from one account to another account. There is no waiting time. Now, people really don't have to, think of a holiday that when can I go and transfer money from my account to my parents' account. That can be done easily sitting at home 24/7. राइट? एंड इसमें कोई लिमिट नहीं है. जैसे आरटीजीएस में देयर इज अ लिमिट, मिनिमम 2 लाख होना चाहिए, यहां पे कुछ नहीं है. आप चाहें तो 10 रुपए भी ट्रांसफर कर सकते हैं, दैट्स अप टू यू. बैंक ड्राफ्ट, आई हैव जस्ट एक्सप्लेन्ड यू व्हाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग रेमिटेंस ऑफ फंड्स दैट व्हाट आर बैंक ड्राफ्ट्स ऑल अबाउट. सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द फंक्शंस ऑफ कमर्शियल बैंक्स एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड लिटिल अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ एडवांसेस एंड फंड ट्रांसफर्स. नाउ लेट अस कम डाउन टू टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट इज द in thing nowadays, okay, that is your e-banking. What is meant by e-banking? Conducting banking transactions online, electronically. All right. Now, when we talk about e-banking, ठीक है, आप best example e-banking का होगा आप लोगों के लिए ATM. हमने अपना ATM यूज किया. नाउ ATM की फुल फॉर्म, मेनी पीपल मेनी स्टूडेंट्स दे विल से एनी टाइम मनी, बट इट इज नॉट एनी टाइम मनी, इट इज ऑटोमेटेड टेलर मशीन. फाइन, यू स्वाइप योर कार्ड, यू कैन विदड्रॉ मनी. फाइन, यू कैन डिपॉजिट मनी, यू कैन चेक योर अकाउंट बैलेंस, यू कैन गेट अ मिनी स्टेटमेंट ऑल्सो. नाउ व्हाट आर दीज? दीज आर बैंकिंग ट्रांजेक्शन्स एंड आई एम कैरिंग ऑन दीज ट्रांजेक्शन्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली. सो दिस इज नथिंग एल्स बट ई बैंकिंग. राइट? आप जाते हैं शॉपिंग के लिए, वहां पे क्रेडिट कार्ड स्वाइप करते हैं, ठीक है, एंड कपड़े खरीद के आ जाते हैं, व्हाट एवर यू वांट टू बाय. व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज लाइक क्रेडिट कार्ड. क्या है कि आप एक शॉर्ट टर्म के लिए काइंड ऑफ शॉर्ट टर्म लोन ले रहे हैं बैंक से, ऑन विच यू हैव टू पे सम अमाउंट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. यू स्वाइप योर डेबिट कार्ड. डेबिट कार्ड और क्रेडिट कार्ड में बेसिक फर्क क्या है? डेबिट कार्ड इज नथिंग एल्स बट इट इज जस्ट लाइक अ चेकबुक. ठीक है, मैंने मेरे अकाउंट में अगर 50,000 रुपीज है, मैंने शॉपिंग की 15,000 की, डेबिट कार्ड स्वाइप किया, स्ट्रेट 15,000 विल बी डिडक्टेड फ्रॉम माय अकाउंट. ओके, बट इन क्रेडिट कार्ड इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. दे डोंट टच माय अकाउंट. इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ अ क्रेडिट दैट द बैंक एक्सटेंड्स ऑन विच इट चार्जेस सम अमाउंट ऑफ मनी. राइट? नाउ व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ ई बैंकिंग टू द कस्टमर्स? नंबर वन, दे कैन परफॉर्म ऑल द बैंकिंग ट्रांजेक्शन सिटिंग एट होम. Okay, it is available to them 24/7/365, right? And this whole concept of e-banking, it instills a kind of financial discipline and satisfaction amongst the people. At any point of time, you can see your bank balance electronically. Okay, so it instills a kind of a financial discipline. आपको पता रहता है कि कब आपके अकाउंट में कितने पैसे जमा हुए कितने नहीं. एक ये भी है बैंक से निकाला दैट इफ यू फिल अप अ फॉर्म दे विल कीप अपडेटिंग यू कि अगर जैसे आपके अकाउंट में से पैसे विड्रॉ होंगे आपको एक एसएमएस आ जाएगा, अकाउंट में पैसे डिपॉजिट होंगे आपको एक एसएमएस आ जाएगा. दिस इज ऑल्सो ई बैंकिंग. Okay, so customer is well aware about what are the kind of transactions that are happening in his account. Clear? What are the benefits of e-banking to the banks? Number one is there are new innovative methods that banks are coming up with. That is making online payments. You really don't have to get into queues anymore. Okay, you can make all the payments online. Secondly, the workload of the banks has reduced quite a bit, as a result of which now they can concentrate on more important issues of that of policy making. Fine, and the time can be used more effectively and efficiently. Last but not the least, banks can spread their services in the areas even where they do not have their branches. Alright, now to give an example ways of e-banking, I have just told you, we have debit cards, we have credit cards, we have your ATM machines, okay, and mobile banking. These all will be the different ways of conducting electronic banking. Okay, to trade that we had read about, that was insurance. What is the basic meaning of insurance? You know, in business, we are always exposed to some kind of uncertainty. We are always exposed to, not only in business, in life also, we are always exposed to some kind of uncertainty, right? So what these insurance companies, they do is that in return for a payment of a small amount of money, okay, or a certain amount of money, let's not call it small, for a certain amount of money, they take our risk on their head. They take our risk on their head, okay? And in case of a loss, they indemnify the amount of loss. Indemnify matlab, hame jitna loss hua hai, okay? Agar humne insurance karai hui hai, to insurance company hame wo paisa वापस दे देती है, obviously after being satisfied that the case is genuine. Okay, now here are basically we are going to be talking about three types of insurances. Okay, but before we come to that, let us first focus on these seven principles of insurance. Okay, first one being utmost good faith. There are two parties in case of in a contract of insurance. One is the insurer, the insurance company, ठीक है, जो आपको insurance provide करती है, उसको हम बोलते हैं insurer, fine. And the other one is insured, जिसको insurance provide कर रहे हैं, उसको हम बोलते हैं insured. They are entering into a contract, ठीक है, जहाँ पे कि insured जो है, वो premium pay कर रहा है, और उस premium की return में insurance company जो है, उसको protection cover provide कर रही है. Right? Now, because when they're entering into a contract, they must be true to one another. They must not disclose any important information. Okay? They must disclose all important points and facts to one another. It is the responsibility of the insured to tell the insurance company agent in detail what all, let's talk about if I'm getting a mediclaim done. So I have to inform the insurance company about my state of health, whatever the present illnesses that I'm suffering from, everything. Because later on, agar ye discover kiya jata hai that you have hidden an important information, then the contract of insurance will be invalid, will be considered as null and void. So the first and foremost principle of insurance is that both the parties to the contract of insurance must disclose all important facts to each other. Clear? Secondly, insurable interest. Insurable interest means a pecuniary interest in the subject matter of insurance. Aap jis cheez ke liye insurance karwa rahe hain, usme aapka interest hona zaruri hai, stake hona zaruri hai. Uske hone na hone se aapko farak padna zaruri hai. Alright, you must have, the insured must have insurable interest in the subject matter of insurance. Fine, like in case of life insurance. मैं किसी राह चलते के इंश्योरेंस नहीं करा सकती, ठीक है, बिकॉज मेरा उससे क्या रिलेशन है, उसका होने ना होने से मुझे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. तो अगर हम ये प्रिंसिपल ना फॉलो करें, मैं किसी की भी इंश्योरेंस करा के नेक्स्ट डे उसको मर्डर कर दूं और मेरे पास इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी अमाउंट आ जाएगा. बट दिस प्रिंसिपल स्टेट्स दैट इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट टू हैव इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट इन द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. Clear? A husband can get the life of his wife insured. A parent can get the life of his children insured. A son can get the life of his parents insured. Clear? Then comes indemnity. Indemnity means to put the person back in the same position as he was before the loss took place. Okay? To indemnify meaning, अगर मेरे घर में आग लग गई, मुझे वहां पे लेट से 60 लाख का नुकसान हो गया, 60 लाख का नुकसान हो गया एंड शॉर्ट सर्किट की वजह से आग लगी थी, एंड आई वाज द हाउस वाज इंश्योर्ड अगेंस्ट फायर. क्लियर? तो इंश्योरेंस कंपनी विल इंडेमनिफाई मी. इंडेमनिफाई मतलब विल पुट मी बैक इन द सेम पोजिशन. अगर मुझे सारा का सारा पैसा इंश्योरेंस कंपनी से वापस मिल जाता है तो मेरा लॉस क्या हुआ? जीरो. जितने का लॉस हुआ था वो तो पैसा मुझे वापस मिल गया इंश्योरेंस कंपनी से. बट इन केस ऑफ लाइफ इंश्योरेंस इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. आपको पैसा तो मिल जाएगा बट आपको लॉस क्या हुआ है? वन पर्सन हैज डाइड. सो इंश्योरेंस कंपनी कैन नॉट इंडेमनिफाई यू, कैन नॉट ब्रिंग दैट पर्सन बैक फॉर यू. ऑलराइट? देन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन. इफ यू आर गेटिंग द सब्जेक्ट मैटर इंश्योर्ड, यू हैव टेकन अ डबल पॉलिसी फॉर द सेम सब्जेक्ट मैटर. ठीक है, मैंने दो जगह से पॉलिसी कराई हुई है. सो इन द इवेंट ऑफ अ लॉस, मैंने अपनी गाड़ी की अगर दो जगह से इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी कराई है, गाड़ी की वैल्यू जो अमाउंट ऑफ लॉस है वो है अबाउट 3 लाख, और मैंने दोनों जगह से 4-4 लाख की इंश्योरेंस करवाई हुई है. राइट? तो अगर मुझे एक जगह से इंश्योरेंस का पैसा मिल जाता है तो दूसरी जगह से मैं जाके इंश्योरेंस का पैसा नहीं ले सकती. आई कैनॉट बी मेकिंग प्रॉफिट इन द नेम ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. Alright, because it is just for the purpose of protection from various risks that you are exposed to. It is not for the purpose of making profit out of it. Alright, thereafter comes subrogation. After, अगर मेरी गाड़ी damage होगी, accident हुआ, गाड़ी damage हो गई, ठीक है, insurance company ने मुझे मेरे पैसे दे दिए, उसके बाद जो मेरी damaged गाड़ी है, I do not have any right over that damaged car. That is the property of the insurance company. They may do whatever they wish to with that car of mine. I have no interest in that. Fine, the subject, the asset or whatever has been destroyed will belong to the insurance company. Then comes causa proxima, meaning that the insurance company will compensate you only if the damage has been caused by the loss against which the protection has been sought. Clear? I'll take the same example which is given in the book, that if you've taken a marine insurance, there is a cargo of goods, okay, which is to be sent, and you've taken insurance against loss which could be caused by seawater. Let us say if there are rodents in the ship or due to the fishes, there are holes caused in the base of the ship due to which the seawater enters the ship and the cargo is destroyed, goods are destroyed. So you are liable to claim compensation since the loss has been caused by seawater. But agar seawater na aaye, rodents hai ya aur rodents ne sara ka sara aapka saman kharab kar diya hai, in that case loss aapko hua hai but it is not due to the proximate cause. Humne insurance kiske against liya hai? Seawater. ठीक है, बट यहां हमारा सामान किससे खराब हुआ? बिकॉज ऑफ रोडेंट्स एंड रैट्स. ऑलराइट? सो यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट एनी कॉम्पनसेशन. लास्ट इज मिटिगेशन. इट मींस इट स्टेट्स दैट द इंश्योर्ड मस्ट टेक ऑल द पॉसिबल स्टेप्स टू मिनिमाइज द लॉस. ओके? इन केस देयर इज अ फायर एट योर हाउस, ऐसा नहीं है कि आप चुपचाप बैठ जाएंगे तो हाँ भाई इंश्योरेंस तो हुई हुई है, मेरे घर की जलने तो पूरा जल जाएगा तो पूरा पैसा मिल जाएगा. नो, दे आर गोइंग टू चेक कि किस समय आग नोटिस की आपने, डिड यू कॉल द फायर ब्रिगेड और नॉट, वॉट वर द स्टेप्स विच वर टेकन बाई यू, ओके, टू मिनिमाइज द लॉस. सो अंडर द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मिटिगेशन द इंश्योर्ड मस्ट ट्राई टू मिनिमाइज द लॉस एज फार एज पॉसिबल, मस्ट टेक ऑल पॉसिबल स्टेप्स टू मिनिमाइज द लॉस. सो दीज वर ऑल द 7 प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द different types of insurances. Number one being life insurance. It will be more appropriate if I say that it is more of an assurance. Okay, life insurance policy is more of a life assurance policy. ठीक है, in this what happens is that you pay yearly premium. आप एक time period के लिए भी ले सकते हैं कि मैंने अगर let us say 20 years के लिए life insurance policy ली, ठीक है, उन 20 इयर्स के लिए आई एम गोइंग टू बी पेइंग अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ प्रीमियम. ठीक है, इन केस आई डाई बिफोर 20 इयर्स, तो अगर मैंने लेट अस से 20 लाख की पॉलिसी ली है, तो जो भी मेरे क्लेमेंट्स हैं, ओके, माय किड्स और हूसोएवर आर द बेनिफिशियरी, दे आर गोइंग टू गेट दैट मनी, फाइन. बट इन केस आई डू नॉट डाई इन दैट पीरियड ऑफ 20 इयर्स, सो एट द मैच्योरिटी ऑफ 20 इयर्स आई एम गोइंग टू गेट माय मनी बैक. ठीक है, जितने की पॉलिसी है वो मुझे मिल जाएगी. सो देयर इज एक्चुअली देयर इज नो एलिमेंट ऑफ रिस्क इन्वॉल्वड इन हियर. रादर इफ यू गेट द अमाउंट एट द मैच्योरिटी, आपका प्रीमियम, आपने जितना भी प्रीमियम पे किया है, ओके, उससे ज्यादा ही पैसा आपको मिलता है. ऑलराइट, सो देयर इज एन एलिमेंट ऑफ कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन आल्सो हियर. राइट, नाउ व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लाइफ इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसीज. नंबर वन बीइंग होल लाइफ इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी. हियर you will get the money only when you die, okay, you go on paying the life insurance premium throughout your life, clear. Second is endowment insurance policy, that is if you've taken insurance policy for a specific period of time, let's say 10 years or 20 years, now the amount will be payable to you or to your wife or son or whosoever is there, okay, only it will be payable in the event of the death of the insured or on the maturity of the policy, whichever happens earlier. Then joint life insurance policy. Let us say if I and my husband, we together take a life insurance policy, in the event of death of either of us, okay, the other person who's alive is going to get the money of the policy. Annuity policy. Annuity policy is generally taken up for the purpose like after retirement, if I'm interested in getting some kind of a periodic payment, okay, so I can start this annuity policy right now, fine, after I have attained a certain age, thereafter maybe monthly or quarterly or 6 monthly or maybe an annually I will get a stipulated amount of money from the insurance company. Then children's endowment insurance policy, I can take insurance policy for the purpose of marriage of my daughter, or I can take an insurance policy for the purpose of your further studies of your children. Alright, so after the expiry of us or on your children attaining a certain age, you are going to get the money for that policy. So these are 5 types of life insurance policies which are available, right? Next is your fire insurance policies. Now fire insurance basically is taken to protect the insured from the loss that may be caused by fire. For this, there must be actual fire which has caused the loss, and it's necessary that fire should be accidental. I can't do this ki maine apni factory ki fire insurance karai about 50 lakhs ki aur khud hi aag laga di factory mein so that I can earn 50 lakh rupees. No, that fire must be accidental. Theek hai, aapke kisi worker ke negligence ki wajah se fire lage to bhi aapko paise nahi milenge. Clear? So it should be accidental, and there should be actual fire which has caused the loss. Then the insurable interest must be present at the time of taking the policy, jab aapne policy li hai, and at the time of the loss. Jab aapne policy li hai, tab bhi factory aapki honi chahiye, and at the time of loss also the factory should be yours. Aisa nahi hai ki maine aaj insurance policy, fire insurance le li apni factory ke liye, factory bech di, now the factory belongs to someone else, aur kal maine usme aag lagwa di. ठीक है, बट आई कैन नॉट गेट द मनी. वाई? बिकॉज आई हैड इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट एट द टाइम ऑफ टेकिंग द पॉलिसी, बट एट द टाइम ऑफ लॉस आई डू नॉट हैव इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट. सो इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन केस ऑफ फायर इंश्योरेंस, इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट शुड बी प्रेजेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ टेकिंग द पॉलिसी एज वेल एज एट द टाइम ऑफ द लॉस. वेर एज इन लाइफ इंश्योरेंस, योर इंश्योरेबल इंटरेस्ट हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ टेकिंग द पॉलिसी, एट द टाइम ऑफ द लॉस इट मे बी देयर और इट मे नॉट बी देयर. राइट, देन in case of marine insurance, insurance is taken against ship or hull cargo and freight. Now when we talk about ship or hull insurance, okay, it involves insuring the ship against the perils of sea. Cargo insurance, it involves insuring the cargo against the perils of the sea. And freight insurance is basically it covers reimbursing the loss of freight cost to the shipping company, fine. And in case of marine insurance, the insurable interest must be there at the time of the loss. It may or may not be there at the time of taking up of the policy, but it must be there at the time of actual loss. Now let us just take a look at this comparative study between life insurance, fire insurance and marine insurance? This often is asked as an important question for 6 marks, right? Number one, subject matter. Let us take the basis as subject matter of insurance. In case of life insurance, it's the human life. In case of fire insurance, it's the physical property which we get insured. And in case of marine insurance, it could either be the ship or the cargo or freight charges. Insurable interest in case of life insurance must be present at the time of taking the policy, right? Then in fire insurance, I've explained earlier also, it should be present at the time of taking the policy as well as at the time of actual loss taking place. In case of marine insurance, it should be present at the time of the loss. Principle of indemnity does not apply to life insurance because the insurance company cannot compensate the insured for the loss. You cannot bring that person back. Whereas it is possible in case of fire insurance and marine insurance. Marine insurance and fire insurance, the principle of indemnity does apply. Then policy amount. Now life insurance can be of any amount, all right, but in case of fire and marine insurance, in case of fire insurance, it cannot be more than the subject matter insured, that is a physical property ki jitni valuation hai, usse jyada ki nahi ho sakti. And in case of marine insurance, it cannot be more than the value of ship, cargo, hull, all right. Then risk or uncertainty. In case of life insurance, there is no risk. As I just told you, that life insurance is moreover a contract of assurance. Okay, that is, you are certain that you are going to get the amount of money that you are giving as premium, you are going to get it back, right? But in case of fire and marine insurance, there is certainly an element of risk which is present. Then element, life insurance is there is an element of protection as well as investment. As I told you, that life insurance, whatever premium you are paying, the amount of money that you are going to get back at the time of maturity is much more than the amount of premium that you have paid. So it leads to capital formation. It basically helps you grow your money, right? So there is an element of protection and investment. Here there is an element of protection only. In both fire and marine insurance, there is an element of protection only. Duration, life insurance is generally from 5 to 30 years, but a whole life, this whole life insurance policy can continue even for more period of time. But fire insurance and marine insurance, for fire insurance only for 1 year, every year you have to keep renewing the policy, and marine insurance 1 year or period of voyage. Loss measurement, in case of life insurance, loss is not measurable, but in case of fire and marine insurance, loss is measurable, right? So these were the three main types of insurance policies that we had to talk about. Now let's move on to health insurance. As we talked about Mediclaim, it covers, when you take a medical cover, you take Mediclaim, it covers basic medical expenses like your hospitalization or the doctor's fees and all, okay? Then major medical expenses like surgery or your knee replacement, fine. Then long-term hospitalization, if you're hospitalized for a long period of time, okay? Then disability income. Now, what is this disability income? It is payment of income to the insured for the time period for which he was disabled due to hospitalization. Okay, this is also a part of Mediclaim, fine. Last but not the least, reinsurance. Now this is a very interesting concept. If ABC insurance company has given an insurance to a particular person, but then it feels that it alone will not be able to cover the entire risk. Agar usko loss ho jata hai, toh maybe ABC company pura ka pura uska loss compensate nahi kar paegi. So in that case, the ABC insurance company takes insurance from another company. ठीक है, यहाँ पे insurer किसी और से insurance लेता है in order to share the risk with him. ठीक है, अगर 30 lakhs के लिए आपने insurance policy ली है, ठीक, किसी को दी है insurance policy, पर आपको लग रहा है कि आप in the event of loss पूरा का पूरा 30 lakhs नहीं दे पाएंगे, loss हो भी सकता है, नहीं भी हो सकता. So अगर आपको लगता है, एक insurance company को लगता है कि वो cover नहीं कर पाएगी, तो वो दूसरी company के साथ, वो दूसरी company से insurance लेती है. Okay, so in this way, here now the ABC insurance company will become the insured, and the new company from which it has taken insurance will become the insurer. That was all about insurance. Now, after having talked about banking services, insurance services, let's now come down to postal and communication services. Now, business, any business unit or enterprise cannot operate in isolation. It has to communicate with other business enterprises. Fine. It has to communicate with various interest groups that it has. All right. And it is this where the postal and communication services come into the picture. Clear? Now, when we talk about the postal services, now, basically, we'll be talking about the mail services. Okay, mail service, postal services में mail services हैं जो post office हमें क्या-क्या services provide करता है, main जो है उनका हमें provide करने का, that is your mail services. Mail services में एक होती है आपकी ordinary post, जहाँ पे कि आप letter box में letter जाके डालते हैं, and then it is delivered to the address which is written on the letter. But इस case में क्या है, जो letter post कर रहा है, उसको कोई confirmation नहीं मिलती है कि उसकी letter दी गई, जहाँ पे उसने address किए वहाँ पहुँच गई है. Fine. To overcome this, ये आया under postal certificate. ठीक है, अब इसमें क्या है, आप जाके letter drop करते हैं, तो post office वाले आपको एक receipt देते हैं, that you have delivered the letter in the post office. Right? But, इसमें एक और drawback क्या है, आपको ये confirmation नहीं मिलती है, कि जिसको आपने letter दी है, उसको मिली के नहीं. Right? Now, then we have registered post. Registered post में क्या है? When you have to send a particular letter through registered post, when you go and deposit the same in the post office, they will give you a certificate, fine, that you have delivered such and such letter on such and such date, okay? And जब वो recipient को मिलेगी, addressee को मिलेगी, ठीक है? तो वो आपको registered post handover की जाती है only after taking the signature of the recipient. Now that's a proof to show कि जहाँ आपने लेटर भेजना था वहां पे मिल गया है. क्लियर? देयर आफ्टर वी हैव पार्सल. इन दिस डिफरेंट आइटम्स, यू नो, एनीथिंग कैन बी सेंड वाय अ पार्सल फ्रॉम द पोस्ट ऑफिस. ओके, दैट इज अंडर दिस सर्विस द पोस्ट ऑफिस सेंड्स हैवी आर्टिकल्स. जो आपके नॉर्मल लेटर्स हैं, दे विल बी सेंड थ्रू रजिस्टर्ड पोस्ट ऑल, बट ऑल द हैवी आर्टिकल्स, ओके, दे आर सेंड थ्रू पार्सल अंडर द रेगुलर एंड द नॉर्मल पोस्ट. Clear? Thereafter we have speed post. Okay? यहाँ पे registered post से थोड़े से पैसे से ज़्यादा लगते हैं, because this is all done by air. Fine, this is done through your air mail services. All right? And they charge you a little more because of the speed. ठीक है? जहाँ पे कि registered post में आज दिया तो कल मिलेगा, वहाँ पे आज का आज ही मिल जाएगा. Right? Then you have courier services. This is generally provided by the private courier firms. Okay? You have Blue Dart. You have first flight, okay? अब यहाँ पे again they are going to be charging extra. जितना आपको post office में charge लगेगा उससे थोड़ा ज़्यादा लगता है. But why do they charge more? Because of speed. ठीक है, सही time पे सही जगह वो आपका letter पहुँचा देंगे. Right? Then what are the other postal services which are available to you? You can transfer money. Okay, through money, or you can remittance of money through money orders and postal orders. Then greeting post, you have those postcards for different occasions, right? Then what do you call media posts? Now it's an innovative vehicle for advertisement for different business enterprises. They can advertise through their envelopes, and they can advertise through letter boxes by putting their hoardings in it, right? Then you have speed post, which we've already covered in your mail services. Then another thing, you have e-bill services also, wherein you can pay your telephone bills, your electricity bills, etc. through post offices, right? You have other saving schemes hote hain, that is public provident fund hai, national saving certificates, recurring deposits, etc. Alright? So, two things that you got to talk about, mainly, jo postal services hume post office provide karega, this is a mail services, fine? And other postal services mein aa jayenge aapke, your money orders also, your saving schemes also, your greeting posts also, your media posts also, and speed posts also, right? Now coming to the telecom services, telecommunication services, this is only a one-way communication, fine? It is in the telecom sector that we have a two-way communication has been made possible. Number one being mobile phone services, okay? You can carry your mobile phone anywhere, fine? And there are different what you call service providers. We have Airtel, we have Vodafone, we have Idea. All right. Now, any two people, theek hai, anywhere in the world, you dial a mobile number and you can talk to another person. okay? It's a cordless mobile communication device which facilitates two-way communication, okay, in a wide geographical area. Matlab, you don't, it's not that नेक्स्ट वाला ये जैसे कि फिक्स्ड लाइन फोन सर्विस जो है, इसमें ड्रॉबैक क्या है कि अगर एक जगह लेट अस से अगर हम MTNL का बात करते हैं, फिक्स्ड लाइन फोन्स का, दैट इवन इफ इट्स अ कॉर्डलेस फोन, ठीक है, उसकी रेंज विल ओनली बी फिक्स्ड टू अ सर्टेन डिस्टेंस. यू कैन नॉट टेक द कॉर्डलेस फोन ऑफ अ फिक्स्ड लाइन सर्विस यू नो विद यू. इफ यू आर इन नोएडा, आई कांट टेक इट टू दिल्ली, इट विल नॉट वर्क ओवर देयर. ऑलराइट, इट इज ओनली गोइंग टू वर्क विद इन द रेंज ऑफ फ्यू सेंटीमीटर्स. Fine. So to overcome that, we have mobile phone services. Both of these, they are two-way communications. Fixed line mein bhi, aap apne ghar se baith ke, theek hai, you can make ISD calls, you can make STD calls, you can make local calls also. Alright. Then comes a pager service. This is just a one-way communication. Okay. Anyone, there is pager ka, har ek pager number hota hai. These, I don't think you guys will be aware of this. But earlier we used to, before mobile phones, we used to have pagers. Theek hai. To service provider ke paas, you just have to dictate the message and a written message will be sent to that particular pager number. Whenever you see the person who's received the message, the recipient of the message can read the message and can take the necessary action accordingly. Then you have VSAT, that is very small aperture terminal. Okay, now it is a satellite based communication services and it's very useful to the business organization, and it's a highly reliable communication facility, and it can be used for the purpose of knowing the stock market situation. Theek hai, it can be used for tele education, right? Then DTH, direct to home services. Okay, best example for this would be these set top boxes. ओके, सैटेलाइट्स लग जाती हैं आपके तो डिफरेंट चैनल्स वगैरह के लिए, टीवी चैनल्स के लिए. दैट इज नथिंग एल्स बट योर डायरेक्ट टू होम सर्विसेज. देन यू हैव योर इंटरनेट सर्विस सिटिंग एट योर प्लेस. फाइन, यू कैन बी कनेक्टेड टू द एंटायर वर्ल्ड, यू कैन नो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ऑल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. दैट हैज बीन मेड पॉसिबल ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इंटरनेट सर्विसेज, राइट? देन ईमेल सर्विसेज, दिस इज अगेन अ टू वे कम्युनिकेशन वेर इन यू कैन रिसीव ईमेल्स एंड यू कैन send emails, any kind of a business communication that takes place via emails. Now we do not have a system of sending letters and all, we communicate with the help of mails, right? Last but not the least, we have fax services wherein documents can be exchanged. Fine, if I have a letter which has to be sent to someone else, the same can be faxed, okay, to another person having a fax number. Uske paas bhi fax machine or fax number hona zaruri hai, to yahan se ek document aram se bheja ja sakta hai usko. Clear? So this was all about your postal and communication services. With this chapter stands done. We've covered three main business services, that is your banking, insurance and postal and communication. Thank you.